Hello student, welcome back to one more session of Analog and Digital Electronics. In this session, we will continue the fifth module of 18CS33 syllabus, that is shift registers and counters. In the last session, we have completed shift register. In this session, we will see the counter. So, students, what is a counter? A counter is an electronic device which counts clock cycle. A counter is an electronic device which counts clock cycle. There are two types of counters. One is called as asynchronous counter, other one is called as a synchronous counter. So there are two types of counters. One is called as asynchronous counter, other one is called synchronous counter. Asynchronous counter is also called as a ripple counter. And synchronous counter is called as a parallel counter. Asynchronous counter is called as a ripple counter or serial counter. So other classifications of counters are up and down counter, up counter or down counter, up and down counter. So let me repeat, counter is an electronic device which counts clock cycles. So based on the classification, counters are classified as asynchronous and synchronous. And other classification of the counters are, asynchronous counters are called as ripple counter or serial counter. I will tell you why it is so. And synchronous counters are called as parallel counter. So other classifications of counters are up counter, down counter based on the direction of counting, and up down counter. So students, first we will see ripple counter or serial counter. So ripple counter or serial counter or asynchronous counter. Why the name asynchronous counter? Because here all the flip-flops which makes the counters are not driven by single clock. Means the first flip-flop is driven by clock, the output of the first will drive the second, the output of the second will drive the third flip-flop. So this is called as a ripple counter or serial counter. So here the output of the second changes only after it gets output from the first flip-flop. Output of the third flip-flop will change its state only after it gets output from the second flip-flop. So here you can see this is also called as mod 8 counter. This is also called as mod 8 counter. Means mod 8 counter in the sense like it will count from 0 to 7, or it is also called as 3 bit counter. 3 bit means here we have used 3 flip flops, so total it is a 3 bit counter. It is also called as a 3 bit counter or mod 8 counter. So 2 raised to power 3 is 8. So that means it can count from 0 to 7. That is the mod 8 counter. Otherwise 3 bit counter. So different names for this counter. Let me repeat once again. This counter is called as ripple counter. Ripple counter because the output changes just like a ripple on water. So ripple counter. The other one is a serial counter. Why it is called serial counter? Because in order to get the output at C, it depends on the output at B, it in turn depends on the output at A. That means it needs 3 clock cycle. All the flip-flops will not change its state simultaneously because clock will drive the first flip-flop, the output of the first will drive the second, the output of the second will drive the third. That's why it is called as a serial counter. Then it is also called as a 3-bit counter because 3 flip-flops are used. Other than that, it is also called as a mod 8 counter. Means it will count from 0 to 7. Now students, you will see now how it works exactly. Here we have connected 3 JK flip-flops in the cascaded way. We have cascaded 3 JK flip-flops. 3 JK flip-flops. So clock is a square pulse which drives the first flip flop. The output of the first will act as a clock for the second. The output of the second will act as a clock for the third. Other than that, we have taken the output at A, B, C simultaneously, and all the inputs like JK inputs are tied to VCC. So tied to VCC. And we know During the negative edge of the clock here, the output changes. During the negative edge of the clock, output changes. Output of the flip-flop will change. Let us see first the output of the flip-flop A. So, since J and K is tied to 1, we know when J is 1, J is 1 and K is 1, output will toggle. The output will toggle. So initially we'll take output is equal to 0. So when J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 1, during the negative cycle of the clock, the output will toggle. During the next negative cycle of the clock, once again, output will toggle from 1 to 0. This will repeat and this will continue. So this output is given to second flip-flop. So the output of the first will act like a clock for the second, and output of the second will change during the negative edge of this one. So these are the negative edge of this one. So these are the negative edge of A. Output of A, negative edge at the output of A, and output of A acts like a clock to the second flip-flop. So now second flip-flop will change its state during negative edge. So initially we will consider 0, because J and K is tied to 1, it will toggle, output will toggle during the negative edge, and it will remain same till the next negative edge. And when the next negative edge comes, it will toggle to 0. Once again, it will toggle to 1. So 0, so on. Now this output becomes clock for the third one, and so third will toggle. The output of the third flip-flop will toggle during the negative edge. So here you can see C remains 0 until the first negative edge comes. After that, output of the C flip-flop will toggle and it becomes 0. So in this way, if you see, this is the output of the counter. Let's write here properly output of the counter. So output of the counter, this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Let me use some other color. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. After that, it becomes 0, 0, 0. This is called as a moderate counter, means it counts from 0 to 7. And this is also called as an up counter, because the counting direction is in the upward, it counts in the upward direction, so it is called as a up counter. So this is the the circuit diagram for moderate counter using JK. We'll see now down counter. Hello student, welcome to the one more session of analog and digital electronics. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. In the last class we have discussed ripple counter or serial counter. So what is a ripple counter, what is a serial counter, and how to construct a 3-bit or mod 8 counter we have seen, and what is up counter we have seen. So in this class we will see what is a down counter. So up counter is counts in the upward direction, down counter counts in the downward direction. That is, for example, in this, in the diagram, it is a 3-bit mod 8. It is a 3-bit mod 8 down counter, means it counts from 7 to 0. There are totally 8 states, 7 to 0. So this is called as a mod 8 down counter. Now, how to construct this mod 8 down counter? To construct mod 8 down counter, first of all, which requires how many flip-flops? First we have to see which requires how many flip-flops. To count 8 state, we cannot use one flip-flop. If you use one, it will count only 2 state. If you use 2 flip-flops, it will count 4 state. So if you use 3 flip-flops, it will count 8 state. So we need 3, because we cannot use 4, because if you use 4, it will count 16 state from 0 to 15. So our design is mod 8 down counter. So we are going to use here three flip-flops. You can see in the diagram, you see in the diagram, three flip-flops, JK flip-flops are connected, and we have given clock to the first flip-flop. So the output of the second, first will drive the second, output of the second will drive the third. Similarly, JK of all flip-flops are connected to VCC. Now, what is the difference between, first of all, down counter and up counter? You have to note a difference, main difference between up counter and down counter. Let me take you to the previous slide. In the previous slide, you can see here, in the up counter, clock will drive the first flip-flop. The output of the first, that is, the output of the first will drive the second. The output of the second will drive, positive output of the second will drive. Let me use word positive output. But in the down counter, negated output of the second will drive the first will drive the second. Negated output of the second will drive the third. So this is the difference between the up counter and down counter. This is the only one difference between the up counter and down counter. And other than that, the truth table also differ from the up counter and down counter, and waveform also will differ. But circuit diagram wise, only the difference is between, like in up counter, the positive output will drive the second, the positive output of the second will drive the third. In down counter, the negated output of the first will drive the second, negated output of the second will drive the third. So now we'll go to the down counter. Here you can see negated output. Let me show you this one. Negated output of the second, first will drive the second. Negated output of the second will drive the third. Other than that, we are taking the output as positive output A, B, C as shown here. And all the other JK input of the all the flip-flops are tied to VCC. So now we'll see the truth table. Truth table counts from 7 to 0. Because it is a down counter, it counts from 7. That is 111 to 000. Totally there are 8 states. That's why it is called as a mod 8 counter. And it is also called as ripple counter. We know why it is called as a ripple counter. Ripple counter because this counter is a in this counter, this is ripple, this is called a ripple counter or a synchronous counter, because here all the flip-flops are not driven by simultaneously by clock signal, single clock signal. I mean, all the flip-flops are not driven by single clock signal. The clock will drive the first one, and output of the first will drive the second, output of the second will drive the third. That means to read the output from the one end to the to read the input to the output from one end to the other end, it requires at least 3 clock cycle in this case. So now we will see the output waveform. So here we have given negative edge triggered clock. So negative edge triggered clock means during the negative edge transition, the output of the flip-flop will change. Since we have given the clock to the first flip-flop, so during the negative edge, the output of the flip-flop will change. Let us take first the output of the flip-flops are 000. Let us take first output of the all the flip-flops are 000. Let us take 000. Now, since J and K is tied to 1, during the negative cycle of the clock, the output of the flip-flop toggles, because we know when J is 1 and K is 1, output will toggle. So now output will toggle, output of the first will toggle. Output of the first flip-flop will toggle. Now second will, since here the output of the first will act like a clock to the second, but we have to remember here, if A is equal to 1, let me write here clearly, if A is equal to 1, then student A bar is equal to 0. That means negated output is given to the second one. So since we have given negated output and clock is negative edge triggered, this becomes positive. That means this also will run during the positive cycle of the clock, I mean the output of the first becomes, the negated output of the first becomes clock to the second, the negated output of the second becomes clock to the third. And here you can see the output of the second will change during the positive clock cycle. You may ask why it is positive clock cycle. See this one, A, the output of the first will act like a clock to the second one. Now during the positive edge of the A, during the positive edge of the A, B will change, output of the B will change. Why? Because see, you know, output of the A is, output of A is 1, but negated output is 0. That negated output is given as a clock to the negative edge triggered, negative edge triggered pin. That means this becomes, point becomes positive. This works during the positive edge of A. So flip flop B will work during the positive edge of A, and you can see here the output of B will toggle and it will remain 1 till the next positive edge of the A, and after that it will go down and it will once again become 1 during the next positive edge of the A. So now the output of the B, output of the B acts like a clock signal to C, and C will change during the negative edge of the, during the negative, C will change during the negative positive edge of the B. So why it is C will change during the positive edge of the B? Because we are giving negated output of B to the JK. So negated output is connected to the active low signal of clock. So that becomes positive. So during the positive edge of B, the output of C will change, and you can see here output of C will change during the positive edge of the B, and it will remain 1. You may ask why it is remained 1, because initially we have taken it 0, and since JK is tied to 1, output remains 1, and after the next negative edge, after the next positive edge, output goes to 0. So in this way, we will draw the waveform of waveform A, B, C for three outputs of flip-flops, and let me write here to better understanding. So first we are taking this 0, 0, 0, after this 1, 1, 1, then it is 0, 1, 1, so 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, then 0, 1, 0, then 1, 0, 0, then 0, 0, 0. So this is exactly the other way of the up counter. In the up counter, it starts from 0 and it just stops at 7, and it repeats to 0, repeat back to 0. But in the down counter, it starts at 1 and 1, 1, 1 and stop at 0, 0, 0. So this is the explanation of a down counter. In the next session, we will see what is synchronous counter and how the synchronous counter works.